Hello, hi, welcome to the second night of the continuing Team Fortress TV coverage of the Team Fortress TV Invitational powered by Twitch. That's right, we have our very own tournament being sponsored by Twitch. Big ups to Twitch John for making that happen. Super, super grateful about all of that. Tonight we have a great game for you guys. We have the Ding Dong Daddies, the favorites returning from last night, facing off against the Blame Game. One of the teams from ESEA's very own Invite Division. I'm Lang. On camera is MathSad, also known as Dash. And I don't mean to alarm anybody on the cast, but there's a goddamn bear in here. It's Alex Seabear Isaac. How you doing?
Ooh, what full name, including alias. Almost busted out my middle name, Lang. Hello, buddy!
Gotta give you the caster treatment. How you doing?
I love listening to someone not me give the intro. And I gotta say, I gave you props last night. I was streaming. I said, boy, my boy Lang has grown up into a fine young caster. And just proof right there. Why am I in here, by the way? This is a video game that I used to, I think, play. It resembles TF2. I don't know, though, Lang. I don't know. I'm glad to be back. We don't need to make a big deal about the being back thing. Somehow there's no one more, no one able that actually is around that knows these players and teams that could cast. So they had me come in, Lang, but it's fine. I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully by the end of it, I'll get to know these players and we can have ourselves a fun time.
Yeah, we asked like 15 people before Bear. Get a Whale wasn't around, Buick wasn't around, Star wasn't around. Pauly Shore wasn't available, so eventually it's like, we'll use Seabear. So, but you know what? I'm glad you're here. I'm excited. We haven't casted together, I feel like, in a really long time.
I know.
Probably, like, multiple years at this point.
I know. That's what I was thinking, too. So that's exciting. I don't want to say that I don't want to be here. I just, I usually allow all the jabs and
I don't want to say that I don't want to be here, but let's just make it
no,
clear.
No, okay, well, that was phrased poorly. I do want to be here. I always love casting, of course, and Lang is my boy. I was going to say, stream chat, I always enjoy the barbs and jabs when I make mistakes. But tonight, bear with me, boys. It's going to be one of those, like, riding the bike for the first time in 82 years. Eventually, we're going to get on it, and it's going to ride. It's going to be fun. But there might be some serious issues before we get to doing 360s and whatnot, Dave Mirra style. Like,
well, you know what, Bear? I feel like there's no pressure, because last night, my mod completely failed and almost ruined a match, so I doubt you're going to do worse than that.
Can we just go live?
Right now. Yeah, so right now we're doing this live on 3, this hot live on 3 that I coded about an hour and a half ago, so it's good to see that it works.
Nice.
Getting this code out. Seabear, I'm going to be mean to you, and I'm going to give you this first mid. Take it away.
All right, cool. So blue side is going to be the, which I guess is the Blame Game, and then Ding Dong Daddies, would be a fun name to say, is going to be on red. Your first mid in like 8 years of casting. We'll see what happens. It's Goody Watch, ladies and gentlemen. I am back, and I'm excited. First kill is going to go to the shootiest with a big Roamer Bomb or Soldier Bomb, and blue is going to clean up alongside it. Only Showstopper and Ranga remain. Showstopper is down. Ranga is trying to be a superhero, but he is super dead. Chingu, who Lang alerted me to as a potential up-and-coming star scout in the making, had himself the last kill there, and Blue wins that mid handily. Lang.
I like that you called him shootiest.
Yeah, I know.
It's much better than shootest.
Shootest. Hey,
shootiest is great. We're gonna change that with our alias script here. Gonna get MathSad to do that right now. Change his alias to shootiest, because we have that hot technology now, Bear. But anyway, as I ramble on about these wonderful advancements in competitive Team Fortress 2, we do have Uber Vantage in favor of the Blame Game, sitting at just now 100%. But oh, Unf getting aggressive there, taking down Chingu. Blame Game actually starting to push in here now, though the Uber is popped. Shootist leading this in with his team. They're really clustered up, keeping everybody alive. Shootist facing off against Alec on the point, and Alec does take him down before actually cratering there. It's like, oh, no, that was that. The Shootist Bear already with the mistakes on the cat. But regardless, first round in the books for the Blame Game.
Interesting. You know, I don't know too much about these teams that I was joking about earlier, but just the fact that you're able to get a quick round on Beauty Woush against two teams that I was led to believe are pretty even, so that's a great start for the team that won. Shut up, Blank. All right, so we're at mid number two. We're going to make it work, boys. We'll see if Ray can get back in here. Big bombs onto the nipple point. Showstopper gets the first kill, and actually the second as well. 2v1 kill advantage for Red. We're going to be evened up here. Teams are deciding whether they want to stay or go. Red does have a man advantage, or I'm sorry, the positional advantage, but that's going to go away with a double kill. UNF, my boy, longtime guy, goes down. Red's trying to hold on to their side desperately. Showstopper has collected his third kill of mid. Medic's trying to keep him up, but he's going to go down here. And now the retreat will finally be queued away. Will he get his Uber in time? He does actually have it, so he's going to pop eventually here if he wants to, or he'll do a slin. No, he will actually pop the Uber, and now Ubers are going to be exchanged. Very crazy mid fight here. Point has not been capped. Finally, probably will be, though. Respawners for Red, if they decide to get very ballsy and run into a mountain of demo stickies and spam, they will not do that. Mid does go, but pretty crazy mid at that, Lang. All sorts of nonsense going in. Play by Ranga tried to get in. And actually does end up getting Sakura with help from Scout Spam. So Medic down at mid, and this weird mid fight continues.
Yeah, nice coordinated aggression there from Ranga and Bank to take down the Medic. Right now we do have the Ding Dong Daddy. He's trying to capitalize this, but Sure Shot actually coming in, almost taking out Maui Waui. And Maui Waui now having to back up and get that health over there in the lobby. But still, Sakura just spawned, Sure Shot is down, Shudis trying to come in and make something happen, going for that play on Maui Waui, but he's going to get shut down at that shutter door. So that's two players down, Maui Waui with a significant Uber advantage, and we're going to see the Ding Dong Daddy start moving into mid here. Blame Game, already knowing that they're at quite a disadvantage in there, their suicide's not quite working out the way that they wanted to. They're going to back up, they're going to start holding their second point. Maui Waui now has his Uber, and they're going to start moving in through this choke here there.
Yeah, they got in. No stickies up for the blue demo. Soldier touches the skybox. Medic is going to be very nice and actually pop on him before he cratered, landing onto the ground. So Showstopper gets some love from Maui Waui, who has got a fantastic name for casters. I hope that he becomes the best medic in the game, and we can always say that name, Lang. I love it.
Maui Waui of Maui the Ding Dong Daddies.
Yep. let's just bottle that and sell it for no money. We do have Uber 4 Blue. They're hanging out upper forward hold. They're deciding whether or not they want to go. This is generally a pretty hard point to push, as you see a lot of spam coming out. Looks like they're committing at least one soldier to the cause here. Medic does drop down as well for Blue. Oh, Sakura! No! He slid one drop.
Oh. Wow, roasting people here on the cast.
Oh, Lang, you know, I can't handle dropped Ubers. It's just, oh. And that's too bad.
Slimmed one. Jeez, it's rough. Oh.
Yeah, well, yeah.
It's hot in here. These hot roasts coming out of Seabear. Regardless, we have Ding Dong Daddies trying to make something happen here. Unt being aggressive there on the lower. We have the scouts. That's Bank rushing in here with Alec falling up. And both scouts are just going to run on the point and cap it. Just getting right in there, even with the taunts coming out there. I'm proud of that push. Going now into this third mid fight, I'm gonna jump into the eyes of one Unf. That is underscore forever I am for me in the cast here, although Dash might be seeing him as Unf thanks to that handy status spec plugin that we have. Unf doing a quick rollout here to that choke, getting good initial spam onto the big door area. We combo a blame game coming up now. Again, taking that initial spam from Unf, but still they're getting up on their elbow area. Shudis being a little bit ahead of his team, getting taken down. Showstopper trying to capitalize off that peg, but extending a little bit too far into the meat grinder that blame game had ready for him. He does get taken down as well. Blank getting their buffs now, trying to advance across this mid, and their flank is going to make work happen here. They're going to clean everything up. It's only Unf left alive. He has a bit of a buff left to work with. He can maybe try to take a fight against Ictus, who is rushing him, but Unf totally unaware of what was happening at the choke. Ictus just makes a beeline for him and is able to take it down, so that's easy. Full wipe for the Ding Dong Daddies there.
And Insom is doing something that I love, like the pug strat. For demos, he's done the sizer play where he goes up and stickies up the spawn, sort of the second choke. But it looks like Red does know they're not going to extend into those stickies. It could have been devastating if they find the medic here. But that is going to be the second point as well. Actually, really liked Umph's play at mid and the team around it. I didn't think that they would get wiped so horribly. But that mid fight went terribly for the Ding Dong Daddies. They do have a Sentry Pyro up. To the roar of the crowd. Everyone loves all that utility biz. But here comes the Uber, 75% for Maui. Big Papa Waui. He's gonna probably get this because there's just so much crap that Blue has to deal with trying to enter in. This Uber has done effectively nothing, and Maui Waui 5 will have his in retaliation. And Lang, we've just entered Guliwaf zone. You wanna push last? You want to? You got Uber? Okay, well, good luck, because you're just gonna get stuffed into a tiny hole.
Yeah, that's sort of the classic Gullywash failed last push that we see. Nothing against, you know, the attacking team there. It's just, it's a really hard last to push. But now we have some flank action coming out of Ding Dong Daddy's here. There's scouts rushing out through that front door right there and managing to catch Chingu out of position. The rest of his team had backed up, but he was still through that choke. Ding Dong Daddy's want to take this right in the mid. The Uber is popped on Showstopper. He's diving deep, shooting at Insom. Almost takes him down and almost takes on Sure Shot as well. They're so hurt. Alec maybe trying to take down Ictus here so he can move through that choke and pick up those weak players over on that flank. Ranga, again, going in deep, but now Maui Waui is left alone and Chingu picks him up with the pistol. Can Bank take down Chingu here? Actually, Chingu stays alive thanks to that backup support of Insom, but Ranga coming in once again on the flank. Fights happening all over the place here, and we have Bank coming in now through the choke, threatening this back cap here on point four, but Insom, Chingu, and Sakura are going to come back and take this fight, and I don't know how much Bank can make happen. Oh! Well, he actually does take down Insom! Bank just making it happen for his team, and now the fight's transitioning on to mid. Alec and Unf really have to make this happen here, but the Uber from the Bland game, shoot, is getting right up in there, doing pretty good damage, but he's separated from his team and they can't quite follow up. So the Ding Dong Daddies are going to back out, and they actually might, yeah, they're coming right back in right now
back
there.
Back cap, though. Yeah, well, Alec is on the back cap here. Both scouts are just being all sorts of cheeky, first time and last time I'll say that. And you're actually going to go. Blue scout couldn't stop the cap in time, and the upstairs, the attic cap, and now Ding Dong, Alec, I got like all dyslexic there, that's fine. fight is gonna go on, Ictus goes down, so one scout down, 4v4 situation, but a nice back cap, and they're actually gonna contain this area for Red. I gotta say, Maui Waui, 20 seconds into that fight, they took back mid, and that push into, like, his medicing was on point. He had some frag video flick heals, he had a couple express heals with the medic crossbow, and then he just got killed horribly at the end. I was, like, so hoping that he'd clutch that somehow. But as now, Ding Dong Daddies have a good situation. Here comes the Uber now. They're not going to catch out the blue combo, who popped way later here. Showstopper's trying to get the old Platinum Shadow Uber and distribute damage. Oh, he's going to get air shot! Wow!
Wow!
And roasted left and right. Oh, shit! Are you kidding me? Blank!
What?
The game just got real, boys. There was, I think, 3 air shots hit in about 8 seconds in this game. That was absolutely crazy. Wow.
That was really great to see, especially from the bird's eye view perspective I had going on there. Hopefully our cameraman was able to catch as much of that as he possibly could. Right now we do have Blame Game moving into this choke here, threatening to fight on this point too, but Ding Dong Daddies don't want to give this up. Maui Maui out here healing up Showstopper. It's not quite enough. Alec actually in the forward spawn as the telescoped Australian does get that body shot on Sakura, so that's the medic down for the Blame Game, and Ding Dong Daddy still have their heels up, so they're gonna get buffed up and walk this through this choke. Right. That's gotta watch out for the hiders. Instom actually here taking the fight, does get taken down by that safety rocket.
We do have Shootist doing the Roamer Spectral. Sorry, I was like just screaming, but he's gonna get taken down. Back in 2007, when I was like one of the best players in this game, like that play works 100% of the time. Worked not at all there. Scouts found him. He got killed horribly, looked stupid. Life of a Roamer. And now Ding Dong, this really crazy round, are pushing second for the fourth time or so. And it looks like they're going to get it pretty easily here. Looking at where the blue combo is, they are back. Showstopper gets his Uber in, and actually they're heading right towards last. The defensive for blue is upriver on the left side, and no, they're not going to commit. Red is going to back out. Sakura is going to have a bit of an Uber advantage, but probably not enough to do anything. We do have a scout underneath right now, Lang, dodging around here. Might actually get a back cap here.
I really like that play from Blangim getting down to the lobby and forcing that Uber, but I'm not sure how well it's going to work from here. Sakura with a dodge of his life, just barely avoiding that suicide play. Coming in from Ranga, we have Shootist out here way on the front lines, making this happen for his team, killing people out on that riverside bank, trying to make the cap happen at last, but Ictus is going to take him down. Shootist still holding things down out here on point two in the yard, getting that cap for his team. Sakura is so close to Uber. He has 90%. And with Insom picking up that late frag on Alec, I think we're going to see Blame Game. Yes, they are going to buff up and push with this Uber right through Big Door here. But Ranga getting that early frag and the force. So it might be possible for Ding Dong Daddies to maybe back out, wait for Alec to spawn, and perhaps come back in the mid, because two members of the Blame Game are down, including Demo.
not a big uber advantage, but they are going to do just what you said and push in here. Very dangerous fight here for the course of this round. You think the winner is going to have a pretty good chance here. It looks like the daddies are going to pull out on top here. Sakura does get out, but he watched three of his buddies die. Shudis does get the spawn to see if he does some more roamer specials. It looks like he is indeed going to go hide in a different spot. We'll see if it works out. He's going to be hiding above the choke point, but the red push is going to be coming through the big door area. Roamer is going to jump away. He's got shiny silver shoes and he can jump a million times and be absolutely fine. But a nice play by Red. They're going to get second and have Uber 4 last year. Forward hold employed by the Blame Game, that's their name. But I don't know that they got. Yeah, they did pop it going. That's exactly what the forward hold's meant to be. They're going to rush the point with the remnants of this Uber. Medic trying to live the dream at cap, but he's not going to. But frags from the back are going to come in, and the daddies looks like they have it. Only Sakura remains, and he is going to die to cap off, which was an awesome round, Lang. We are now 2-1 in favor of the daddies.
So I'm going to be watching Insom as we move into our next mint here. I think I actually know him more as a scout player, but he's been playing Demoman for I think at least few seasons now, having a fairly decent mid roll, but I think Anth was maybe just a scotch faster than him. Still, Insom getting good spam onto the Ding Dong Daddies as they come out through the big door, but still, Showstopper leading that soldier jump up for his team. Shudis now responding, but Ranga coming up from the side, doing really good damage and distraction, but unfortunately, it still seems to be an even fight for both teams, but as I say that, the scouts of the Blame Game, that's Ictus, making the frags happen for his team. Alec is so hurt on this midpoint, and whoa, crisp pipe from Insom. You can hear him snap into that like a Slim Jim. I don't know what that was, Bear, but I'm just going to go with it. Great frag from Insom, picking up that scout, securing that mid for his team, but both medics have survived, both Sakura and Maui Waui of the Ding Dong Daddies.
Are you getting warm yet, Ubers. Lang? I know you started feeling it yesterday during the comeback. Are you feeling it yet?
I'm feeling something.
Okay, you're getting a little percolated. Keep us updated on the Lang status. We actually don't have both Ubers being popped. A much better situation here for Blue. Bank is going to go down here. There goes Maui Waui trying to surf bullets, but that is not going to work. He is going to go down. Red is going to wipe, and I think this is going to be your fourth round here. Unf is alive. He's trying to get back to last. He's going to have to hit every piece of damage. He's going to fight the demo right away, and that's not a great start here. Actually, he does actually end up killing him in some somehow, even though he got piped twice by him. That's fine, whatever. It's TF2, ladies and gentlemen. And actually, the daddies are going to hold this. I thought that was for sure gone, but you know, I don't really know that much about things, and they just help because it's Ghoulie Wash, you know, whatever. We'll just spawn and drop down and kill everybody.
Because it's Ghoulie Wash, that's, again, how the last push on this map kind of tend to go. Ding Dong Daddy is recapping their second point here. Uber is pretty much dead even for both teams here. But still, Ding Dong Daddy's sort of poking, chilling and poking over at the choke here in some with that spam. I'm not quite sure where Sticky Trap is. Oh! The Sticky Trap was hidden in the, I don't know what that thing is there, but that prop, whatever you want to call it, just barely did not kill the people coming through the choke, though. But Ding Dong Daddy is really sort of getting separated out there. Oh, wow, this is almost a full wipe for them. They just got destroyed at that choke, and that is going to be a full wipe as Chingu runs through and picks off Maui Waui before he is able to get to safety. And that was really just disastrous for Ding Dong Daddy. It seemed like their aggression was staggered, and Blame Game did a good job of realizing that and picking him off one by one. And they're taking this right into last, Seabear.
It actually got it this time. It was like, well, I think they're going to be able to win this round now. I think that they've got the right setup, you know, six up, six down. They're all in the actual physical point, and then they just, like, all type kill in console. Like, oh God.
Aww.
We're tied up here, boys. 2-2. Nice round. Blue seemed to dominate basically every facet, and yeah, that mid sort of get caught in the choke there. That could have gone better for the daddies, but it's all right. We will take the two. I love close games. On Ghoulie Wash, seems like we always get good games here. So we're at mid fight number 5. Chingu is going to be the first to go down to bank. Here comes the staggered bomb from Blue trying to take control of the nipple. They're going to do so, but it's pretty even 4v3 situation. The daddies have advantage. Medic is alive for both sides. And it looks like Insom is going to watch Ictus die, and he's going to take the last remaining member of his team, his medic, back, and they are going to tuck away. It looks like they will get Uber. I don't think they're going to be able to defend two, though, Lang. So the daddies have a nice chance here to take a 3-2 lead into halftime if they can get this last push right.
Nice aggression from Unf there, getting up into that riverside early, placing that trap, is able to pick him up himself a frag onto Shudis. So even though the Ubers are even, Ding Dong Daddies do have a one-man advantage if they decide to push this right now, and it looks like they might. Their buffs are all clustered here on that riverside. Showstopper trying to clear things out, open it up for his team, and they are committing, judging by this positioning. Yes, the Uber is popped. Showstopper getting immediately on the point, forcing the blame game to all sort of collapse there. But the heavy, the Russian wall of meat, that is Ictus, is keeping the other members of Ding Dong Daddies out on that riverside, and they are going to actually force to back up here as they are two players down. A little fight happening underneath. That's Bank trying to get that cap, the distraction play for his team, ensuring the safe retreat of the combo of Ding Dong Daddies. But still, we have Blame Game pushing out here. Shootist leading the charge with that jump, forcing Ding Dong Daddies to play a little bit conservatively at choke as Rango responds with a zone jump, trying to get that distraction. As reinforcements can get through choke cleanly, but it looks like Blame Game are getting the better of this. Their flank has the better coordinated spam. Ictus picking up that late frag onto Alec, and I think with two players down for Ding Dong Daddies, we're going to see Blame Game push right in the mid here.
Did too much bleeding by the Daddies. They actually probably could have held on to two if they played that a little bit better, but I made some miscommunication. You can't keep losing one or two guys in transition, or else you're never going to have a good fight. But they're gonna dig their heels in here and try to stop them. And Showstopper had a great chance, but couldn't finish up. Actually got knocked down underneath the point. His Uber is done, and Blue Uber has just started. And disaster for the Daddies as Blue is gonna. Oh no, Lang. Oh no.
I think we might have a pause. Oh. I'm hoping it's a pause and not something worse.
I don't have the red text of death on my top left screen of screen, my screen, so I
some
think
screen.
It's a pause, yeah.
I think this is a pause, so let's see if I can figure out what's going on. I'm going to talk to these teams here. Bear, why don't you tell us who's sponsoring this tournament?
Oh yeah, it's apparently Twitch is sponsoring. I think
apparently. Actually
it's just Twitch John has been so awesome, and it's a Twitch Invitational. I came back a couple days ago, logged on to teamfortress.tv, the central hub for all things TF2, and I saw the Twitch TF2 Invitational, and I kind of did the comical thing where I opened and closed my eyes real fast and like rubbed them like, did I read that right? And yeah, Twitch is sponsoring a TF2 event, which is so cool, and it's going well. It's through SIBO, apparently, which Lang is the god of.
I don't know about that.
Assumed admin full control, and no one better in the world. He is managing esports left and right. And yeah, this is great. I'm looking forward to see where this tournament ends up going. I always, back in the fully charged days, I would opine about how we don't get enough of high intermediate versus high invite in matches and so on and so forth. That really, you sort of only play what's generally above and below you in a few rungs of the ladder here, skill-wise. You don't get to go way up or way down and really play someone different. So this tournament and stuff like this is really cool, and I'm excited to see if there's going to be any underdogs and what is going to come out, individual players or teams sort of make names for themselves, and certainly something that's fun.
So Bear, I have been informed of the reason why we have a pause. Turns out that Alec of the Ding Dong Daddies
died.
Was on auto retry to a DM server.
Nice.
And he got in.
And he's got to play it out, man.
He's like, I got to warm up, guys. Let's give me a minute. So he's getting back in. but while we wait for that to happen, we have this hot pause here. So going to enjoy that.
Man.
But yeah, I absolutely agree with what you said. You know, it's nice to have these tournaments, these sort of mixer tournaments where the teams aren't, you know, so stratified into their divisions. And you really do have a chance for these teams and sometimes just individual players to have breakout performances and, you know, really get their names out there and get the recognition that they deserve. So huge props to Twitch for helping to make this happen.
Yeah, and it's a $2,500 prize pool, which is nothing to shake a stick at. Wait, is that what you do with something that's like a pretty awesome prize pool anyway? Like, you don't shake a stick at it. That's something else.
No. I would never shake a stick at Twitch John. I'd shake something else, but not no.
Well, he'll shake a bigger stick back at you, buddy. So you better look out.
A fatter one, not necessarily.
I guess, yeah. You'll get, yeah.
So, apparently, this pause actually might go on for a while because some players are taking advantage of the pause to perhaps go do other things. So I'm actually going to ask that our cameraman go to an intermission screen briefly so we're just not blabbering for 5 minutes here.
Is it really going to take 5 minutes? Wow. What the heck?
Yes, that's what I'm being told. But I promise you we will be back. The moment this action goes live, our cameraman will be watching that like a hawk. Don't go anywhere, though. This is the Team Fortress TV Invitational powered by Twitch. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. Alright, so we're back. Teams have unpaused. I promise you haven't missed any action. They've only been unpaused for a few seconds here. Everyone's back. We're back in this video game. We have Ranga now in this lobby here for the Ding Dong Daddies, trying to maybe stall out the push, but knowing he's going to back up here. I'm not quite sure where the Ubers are, because of course, as happens with any pause in our game, it breaks the caster HUD. Nothing that our streamer can do about it. It's just going to be broken for about 90 seconds here. Blame game, luck. Okay, just kidding. Apparently we have these hot new plugins that fix this stuff. I don't know. Internet's crazy. Blame game, being aggressive here in that lobby, peeking through that shutter door. I can see now, thanks to the miracle of these hot plugins that we have, that Sakura is at 100% Uber, whereas Maui Waui is only at 80%. Sakura popping his Uber immediately, rushing in here, leading the scout and soldier in. But the frags right now are in favor of Ding Dong Daddies. This pyro is doing just a ton of work for them. And the Uber is now popped from Maui Waui. And it looks like this is going to be a successful defense from the Daddies, Seabear.
Yeah, again, Gooly Wash pushing last. Pyros is so good. You can just move players around. We still have a scout running around. He's very low, 18 health for Ictus. Just dodges through the medic arrow goes through his legs as he jumps upper and is going to escape for now and regroup back up with Sakura, who's now going to be building Uber. I'm way too lazy to do whatever magic that you have been doing. I believe Ubers are deadly even. They're deadly even, boys.
They're deadly even.
It's getting real. We do have a sniper cam right now. Alec, who every time Lang says his name, I think he's directly talking to me, so I stop not paying attention and try to pay attention, and then I get mad. But missed a shot up river. I don't know if he'll stay sniper for defensive purposes. Not a great sight line. Definitely very powerful for the attackers. I'm switching through here. I don't see any utility classes in blue for the attackers. We do have both Ubers now up. And are we going to see a repeat here? We do have a sentry gun being built in what I like to call the fun corner for defensive side. And that'll just make everything just a little bit more miserable. Here comes Roamer action. Does get in. Gets a nice rocket. He's got shiny shoes. Lang touches the sky. Will jump with no health and get killed. But that was actually pretty close to forcing the pop. And we'll see what happens. Gun is being moved to a slightly more fun location, but still not going to be the most fun to try to push into that level 2 gun underneath.
Yeah, so Maui Waui still holding his Uber, not being forced by the suicides there. Of course, Sakura still has his Uber as well. Sort of the classic Gully Wash last stalemate here. Both teams just throwing stuff at each other until something happens. Of course, you do have Bank still on the NG. Actually, moving his gun around now, moving it over to the secret area. So that's nice. I like that, keeping things fresh. But Alec with the pick onto Ictus, the full charge body shot, it looks like. And I wonder if Ding Dong Daddies will maybe have a little bit of aggression here to try to capitalize off of this, but it looks like they're still playing this pretty safe and pretty passively.
I did a HUD reload scheme, Lang, completely crashed my game, so why don't you keep talking, buddy?
Oh, by the way, yeah, they recently patched TF2 and added that in. The most recent update made it so that HUD reload scheme crashes the game, so.
Just clean, straight up, right to desktop in a half second. That was awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's the game that we cast. I don't know about you guys watching at home. But Ictus with a headshot onto Alec. So this is going to open things up for the Blame game. They are starting to get aggressive a little bit, trying to decide if they want to take it through the shutter or through Riverside. Just a couple precious seconds they're losing here. And their Uber pop is really indecisive. And Insom, the demo leading this Uber, I don't know how I feel about this. And they're getting juggled right on the way in. I feel like they did not know what they wanted to do with that. And they're immediately running out. And now the Uber pop from Ding Dong Daddy's Showstopper getting that frag onto Insom. So that's the first pick, the first domino to fall. Let's see what else happens here. Showstopper! Was that a triple inside of the lobby? What was that? That was crazy. Sure Shot playing like he's back on Sway Gaming here, and it's 2008. I can't believe it, Seabear.
Yeah, dude, that could have very well been me, 11 years ago when I played with Sure Shot, and you just tripled me for fun. That was sick. I don't know if that necessarily counts. His feet were his toes might have been touching the ground, but Rank is going to lose his mind in a physical sense. Bullet meets brain. That is your pocket soldier down, and Maui Waui's like, yeah, that wasn't very cool. Let's not let that happen. We have mini crits onto Sure Shot, so he's now joined the land of the dead, but here comes the push here. A nice entry, a ton of damage being dumped out by the blue demo here. He's got a hamburger in his mouth as Insom pausing the game to go get some McDonald's. He's going to drop damage. Here comes Blue. They're going to be able to cap this, I believe. Red is trying to hero hold. Sniper shot on last. He's going to walk in. But oh my god, the demo's still alive. UNF is hanging out in sneaky. Oh, UNF gets the knife onto Sakura. But he's going to blow himself up for a crazy finish in the first half. Lang. Wow, what the hell is that?
So when she said he has a hamburger in his mouth, at first I didn't realize what you were talking about, and I was like, that's a weird hat. I didn't know they added that.
It totally like, is.
I just...
The unusual pickle effect, man.
Yes. All pickles are unusual, let's be real there. Pickles are weird.
Well, that was the old 11 die last defense slash push, and this the 12th person just is a sniper, walks on the point with like 50 health and wins it. So that was pretty crazy, pretty awesome game, regardless of the stupid pause. And so pretty close. We so what do you think about the first half there, big guy?
I really liked it. You know, 3-2, can't ask for a much better half than that. I mean, despite the pause and some shenanigans that may or may not have happened, that was a really good game. We saw some really intense, long rounds. I feel like that half went, you know, almost right up to the time limit for it. I'm super excited about these matches. So far, all these Twitch Invitational matches that we've casted have just been great, really close.
And Twitch chat, let's take predictions on why we're going to pause in the second half here. It's like, I got to open my mail. Sorry. I got to write my... a rent check out and walk to the mailbox and put it in there. Can we just pause? Actually, no, pause has to come in first and then do it. I'm salty about it, Lang. We're trying to make it to the big time here. This is a Twitch Invitational, boys. Act like you've been there. Anyway, second half, I think we should just get right into it here, Lang. I'm anxious to keep this up. We are going to go live. Your code is working. Computer's fixed, I guess, or computer coded, and we're going half.
Let's see if this live on 3 works before we pass judgment bear.
Totally got it, Lang. So good. We're going to switch sweaters, it looks like, here. I believe, right? Yeah, the ding-dongs were red last time. So the ding-dong daddies are going to be blue, and the is going to be red. We'll see if Sure Shot is going to hit another triple air shoot in this round. We're at mid fight number 6 here. We'll see where the momentum's going to start here. It looks like blue is going to take it right away. Ding dong daddies get the first two. Insom and Chingo go down. That is scout and demo, and there goes soldier, and they're just going to be crammed out of here. In fact, medic did die as well. Sakura went down, so a dominating mid win for Maui Wowie and company, not losing a single soul. And it looks like a mini crit sticky found Shirsha at the tail end of that fight, which is horrible news. No pocket now for a forward hold. It looks like Ding Dong Daddy's Lang are going to cram right into last as soon as possible. And they do have some utility up at last. The Russian is out. The gun is a spinning, but I don't know if it's going to be enough.
So Uber right now completely in favor of the Ding Dong Daddies. It's actually being popped right now, getting in through that shutter area, getting launched a little bit by Insom, but I think that all that did was do them some favors, is let them close the distance. But still, frags kind of going both ways here. Two players for the Ding Dong Daddies, actually three players for the Ding Dong Daddies dying in that engagement, whereas only Shootist from the playing game died, and he's actually going to respawn right now.
That push entered serious fail zone. But it's tough, man. It's you have to be very direct with your movements, and last, you have to use that Uber. You have to get at least a couple picks to start out with, value picks. You can't let the demo just rain down damage. Here comes Big Bomb is going to come in, and some nice timing between Showstopper and Alec, and look at Alec go. Got two. Wow, that was some awesome coordination. They're going to clean up everything capping the point. There was some return frags. There's actually a 3-on-3 situation. Soldier's trying to get aggressive on the red side, but he gets dominated down with the MGE spam. I'm going to shoot the wall where you're going to double from, and that is going to scare Shootist or Shootiest, or I'll just keep adding vowels in his name, Shootiest, until I die. Nice, really nice play by the Ding Dong Daddies. That looked that was some invite-level play there. That was really nice.
The Shootiest of all the shooters. We actually have Chingu sitting here on the crouching pyro hidden pipe up there. So I think he's going to do work here when that Uber comes in. Right now, Maui Wowie again on that Uber advantage, but Ranga on the offensive heavy. The Uber coming in, and once again, Chingu just juggling. So he goes down quickly, but he still stalled out a lot of that Uber and forced it to be split. Both scouts, Ding Dong Dead's getting on that point. A lot of cap time is going. Shootist dying on that point. The Russian, Ranga, bringing up the rear with the Russian Wallaby, and it's just Sakura Uber on the point by himself, but those notoriously long Gullywash last spawns are going to be too long. Not even a full Uber can delay long enough, and that round is gonna go in favor of whichever team won that round, because I already forgot.
Yeah, it was Sakura with the ridiculous play. Didn't end up doing anything as Ding Dong Daddies tied up, but Sakura, who had like 80% Uber, got the swing, tried to Uber the last guy that was alive, died right as the beam was about to touch him. Almost was one of the coolest medic plays ever. Now it's like top 285, so get wrecked, Sakura. But we're at midfight number 7, and it's a nice one. Pretty close as far as frags go, but it looks like is turning around. Red side controls upper, and it looks like Maui Waui is going to try to get his own swing to get Uber. But Chingu's warming up, dropped 3 in that fight, and he is already on second with his medic in tow. And a nice right back at you mid here, trying to get that round back. This has been one of those weird games where you would think that, you know, one team wins a round pretty convincingly, but the next round the other team wins also basically as convincingly. I never really got that about our game, but it's just sort of weird. Like, execution one side just crushes it, and then the exact opposite happens. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, a lot of momentum comes into play, certainly in this game when it's played competitively. We do have the getting their experimental progressive push in on the riverside here. The Uber pop now, and Insom once again getting juggled immediately by the Sentry, Pyro, and demo spam, but 2 frags. Actually, no, that's the Sentry going down. They're just clearing that up with the coordinated spam, and they're falling in Insom. Once again, a lot of demo Ubers coming in from these teams here. Sure shot up on the point.
Oh,
the scouts,
Maui,
that's Chingu. Maui Waui!
Did the exact same thing! He did that's the exact same thing that happened last round. He also almost healed the guy with his Uber. What the hell is going on in this game? Like, that's one of those once in a week of scrimming this game or playing this game, you know, like one every 10 scrims or matches, you see the medics swing and get Uber from it. We saw it back-to-back on last, almost clutched it twice, so okay, teams, you need to calm down. We are now Dormi in favor of Zablam Gam. Can they bring it back and push Ding Dong Daddies to one in one in this group stage here? Sakura is going to be the first death, always the worst possible thing when your medic dies first. It's a great spot for Maui Waui and company here, but they're very low on life. Here comes the bombs. Can the blame game get them in time? No, Ictus is alive. He is not in the fight, though. Medic is going to be able to buff the rest of his guys up. That was really close. One might say, Ling, it was nipple hairs away from going in the opposite favor, but as we stand, the Daddies do take mid, have Uber basically ready to go, so we might have a right back at you for the third straight round, flip-flopping. Now make it 4-4. I think it's just going to have to happen. I think we're going to see a 4-4 here, buddy.
I think it is going to happen. So Ding Dong Daddies with about a 75% Uber advantage. Now by the time they push in, it'll probably be a little bit closer to 50. They're playing very careful, making sure there's no stickies or hiders over here on that riverside. Maui Waui buffing up all the members of his team. Bank catching a little bit of spam there as he's trying to push in, but now the stickies are being cleared. Showstopper leaving the Super for his team with a Pyro once again. So strong here on that riverside. He's keeping everybody out. He delayed that entire Uber. Only Showstopper got in. He got picked off. But Ranga has gotten up onto his little high ground area with the heavy. But Ictus has already spun up. But actually, the cap is snuck in from Bank going in through the riverside. And as Seaver so wisely predicted, we are at 4-4 now. Next round takes it.
Nice, I love it. First cast in so long, since really the last LAN, I think, and we see a great game, 4-4. For all of you who struggle pushing Ghouli Wow Shalast, exploit that river. That push couldn't have gone worse for the first 4 seconds, but they ended up taking it by getting scouts on the point, forcing the defensive team to go down and try to stop it. But that's fine, we are here at the all-important last mid-fight here, unless we go to some Golden Cap BS, and that would be ridiculous, so we're not going to entertain the idea. And you know what the blame game is going to say? We are winning this game! Maui Waui, though, is still alive. All 5 rest of his team are dead, and he is probably going to die as well, doing his thing, switching weapons, and that's actually, like, the worst possible thing to happen, because Medic dies very, very late into this mid-fight. Second is going to go down before Maui Waui peeks his head back into the living, and they're going to have to pull out every Ghouli Waush strat in the game, Lang, to try to defend this here.
Definitely. Sakura with a full Uber advantage. Maui Waui just now meeting up with players on his team and starting to heal, but this Pyro, we've seen the Pyro do so much, but the Uber this time not coming in through the riverside, coming through that front shutter door there, but that Sentry is scaring them off. They were totally caught off guard. They weren't ready for it. Showstopper now trying to make the damage happen in lobby. Gets good spam, manages to not die there, which is really, really good, but still, you know, they have one player down. That's Ictus. It's really hard. Actually, no, that's the blame game has Ictus down. My apologies. I'm so excited here. Can't keep track of what is happening. But now Maui Waui has a slight Uber advantage, and we have that Ghouli Wash reset. I think we're going to move into a stalemate pattern here now.
Ooh, I don't like that pattern very much. We do have a sniper. Ictus has gone sniper. He solo capped, I think, to end the first half. And there goes Alex Brains all over the wall. It's actually sniper on sniper love. Ooh, you got to pay double for that, usually. So that, I don't know if a push off of it. It's really, I mean, you just had Uber versus no Uber. Chingu's going to go down. Ranga trades. Ictus is going to blow off Ranga's limb, we'll say an arm. And now we're sitting at a 5v4 situation. Sakura! They actually, both medics have Uber, so, yeah, I think we're just gonna kind of wait. I don't know. I mean, it's like, yeah, we got our pick, but it's, yeah, we really don't want to go in anyway, so get another pick, guy, please. And now they've all spawned, so, yeah. Now it looks like there's gonna be pressure coming out of the river, which is that far right side for the defensive. Sniper is scoped up here, Lang, so we'll see if he gets, the shot of shots. I'm trying to think of the really famous TF2 shot that was made. I think Sizer may have gotten, like, a ridiculous shot against Mixup at some point.
Justin got that one, the land that Shambud went to, where he shot the medic through that jumping soldier's legs, attacking Badlands last. That's pretty, that's probably the most infamous sniper shot I can think of. But, we have an Uber engagement going on here, Bear. I'm gonna snap back to reality here. Both Uber, actually, no, just no. Uber from Maui Waui is popped, and Ictus getting that pick onto Ump. So the defending demo man is down. Alec has to do so much work with this Pyro right here, spamming away this Uber. But the Ubered heavy in last. Chingu picking up two frags, make that three frags. Is he gonna pick up a fourth here and maybe a fifth? Ranga doing everything he can, getting taken out, and Chingu just cannot be stopped on this heavy bank. The construction worker just whacking away at Sentry, but he is going to go down, and that is GG. That is the Ding Dong Daddies losing that. So, wait, I'm so confused, Bear. I'm sorry. I'm doing like seven things at once.
I know. It's totally okay, Lang. The Ding Dong Daddies, in fact, lost that.
Yes.
That is a GG for the Blame Game, who end up winning, which was a really awesome game. So maybe a little bit of an upset. Now I'm curious, boys, are we going into a second game?
So, I actually have just pasted Source TV to our casters and cameraman. And we actually have a match in progress right now between Renta Homies and Street Hoops Esports. I'm connected into the server right now. I think we are going, yes, we are going into the fourth round of this match. It's currently Street Hoops at 2, Renta Homies at 1. Just starting our fourth round here, watching the mid rollouts as our cameraman is connecting here. Gonna go into the eyes of Grape here. I kinda wanna see what Grape do on this mid fight.
Do we know what the score is? Sorry,
I don't know. 2-1 in favor of Street Hoops Esports right now.
Okay.
Very, very strong mid coming out from Street Hoops. Actually, a full wipe. Every single member of Renta Homies going down there. So that's really unfortunate. So we're going to see Street Hoops Esports cap up mid. They're going to have a scout. Actually, they're pushing into last already. This is super, super aggressive coming out of Street Hoops. And are you in the Source TV yet?
Yeah, I'm watching. Duan has got the right door stuck off. It's really aggressive stuff. I don't see a world in which they're going to be able to break this. Oh, Duan didn't actually debt on the guy who came out his door. They're going to pop Uber. I still believe Blue's got this. Street Hoops is going to clean up pretty much everything on last here. We still have some scouts on the backside. John Milton is going to try his best. And actually, the demo is sneaking River. Maybe too aggressive. I really like that, but then it didn't work. Here comes the medic swinging that big old saw around, missing everything. Oh, nope, see you later, guy. But that's just one tally, one notch on the bone saw handle. He's collected himself a demo mang. But that is a nice hold by Renta Homies. I thought they were done for sure.
Yeah, very well done by them, absolutely. Although I gotta say, I was watching Kozen's POV during that. I don't know how his other bone saws didn't reg. It was some bullshit. But in any case, we have Renta Homies getting out here. Goku doing a good job of being really aggressive onto Duatna, taking pressure away from the rest of Renta Homies. Oh!
Wow.
With the mid-air quick headshot onto Goku. Oh, my, be still my heart. That was a wonderful shot. And that is going to stall out the aggression from Renta Homies. But still, the homies do have about a 25% Uber advantage here. So, yeah, I think they're going to be able to successfully defend at the very least.
That was a ridiculous shot. Get that guy into auto aim right now. Holy moly. Man. All right, so yeah, the sniper on holding two obviously wants to use that to get a pick into last here. Looking at the red defense setup, they're not employing a total forward hold at this point, so I do believe that Street Hoops, when they get their Uber, will be able to walk in. We do have stickies up for Rikachu, ready to drop the big lightning bomb or whatever that Pokemon does. Shut up. And yeah, he's got him just kind of laying there. It's like a child with his toys, but they're about to get like 8 kills, watch. Okay, they see them on the ground right in front of them. Okay, cool. So that is gonna not work, and they're gonna back off here. So I wanna watch my dude and see if he's gonna get another ridiculous headshot. Paragong. Guessing it's just Paragon, and he is looking for a shot. It's really hard. Ooh, he's gonna get a headshot. Combo off with Duat and a Sticky to drop Fusion Soldier down. 5v6, here comes the push right away. They're gonna go in up top right, cue off the defensive Uber. Rikachu is trying to get damage onto the door behind the push. Sentry Gun is up behind in River. I actually don't know if I've seen that spot too many times, but okay, Duat has poked his head back in. He's got his medic here. He's dumping a ton of damage onto the red team, and I think the Rent-A-Homies are gonna pause and go cook themselves some red meat, Lang.
Yes, that seems to be the trend tonight. So, just sort of examining the positioning here.
Whoa.
Whoa, very quick pause. We're actually live again. Oh my god, frags happening every which way. Rikachu with the mini crit roller onto a equalizing soldier, I guess. Paragon with the SMG is pea shooting people down. And that's going to be the end of our first half here. 3-1 in favor of the Street Hoopians. Bear.
Yeah, ridiculous fight. By the way, I want to point out, boys and girls, the thing that I love the most, I don't know if our cameraman can get a shot of this, but what do I love, Lang, about the red team right now?
I mean, I don't know.
Hit tab.
The avatars, the
yes,
fact that one
dude!
Player
okay.
has, okay.
Listen, if you're on a clan, I'm gonna get on a soapbox here, boys and girls. If you're in a clan or a team, a TF2 clan, and you guys play scrims, I want
your practice clan wars.
Yes, your PCWs. I want you to do things with your avatar. I think it was a picture of Tyrone or something that was spelled out in the avatars one time, and matching avatars is a thing of beauty. It used to be like every clan that you would scrim back in the day would have it, and now only the coolest of us remain. There you go. I'm off my soapbox. I want more matching avatars. Let's go. Most famous, by the way, of those would be the Randy Besserman and the Besserman 6 avatars, featuring Blackie Monster's ridiculous face posted on all sorts of different things. Lang, back to you.
RB6, taking me back. Oh, wow.
For the five people in chat that know what I'm talking about, I hope that you got a laugh out of that.
The other five people that were on RB6, yeah, they're all here. They're all here. See other boys, see Bear casting.
Goat Trilly's like, yeah, I love that. Avatar. Shut up, Bear. You're drunk. Okay, I'm going home, too. Alright, talk about these teams a little bit, Lang. I see a lot of people I recognize on Street Hoops feel like they're probably the big favorites. They've won. We're gonna go live here, but I assume that they are, you know, favorites to win in this game? Yeah?
So there seems to be some kind of bug in the mod. I'm not sure what happened. The game seems to be going live, though, so let's hope for the best. Moving into the first round of the second half here, gonna be watching, Deadpool. Let's watch a scout on this mid, see what he do. Got a big fat buff moving into mid here, gonna try to play it maybe off the aggression of his soldier that's hanging down in lower there. That Bolt trying to pressure Rikachu, take that pressure off of his team. He's falling back, so I'm gonna watch someone else here. Ash now with the bomb. He's got clean damage onto. He's so close to taking out Rikachu, but Devolt does come in with the assist, finishing off that kill. Paragon following up with the aggression, taking down Fusion. Servo trying to open things up a little bit for the Rent-A-Homies. Now, this is all a war here. This is John Milter and Servo left alive for Rent-A-Homies, but the health on Street Hoops is kind of not great, so they might be able to make something happen, but Server does get taken down by Grape there. It is just John Milter, and he takes down Paragon. John Milter still being aggressive here. He can maybe take down Kozen. Kozen is going to survive. He's got his Uber just now taking over to 100%, and they're going to get ready to push into the yard area here.
I love that Paragon and Deadbolt for Street Hoops just velociraptoring, just taking chunks out of people at mid, just hopping around, hitting the meat with their scatter guns, doing a ton of damage. Ghouliwash is great if you can sort of get out of that initial demo spam for scouts, just hop around and dump out all sorts of bad intentions onto people here. And Goku's going to go down here. Duwana continues to always have pedal to metal, and he is pushed into last here, using that Uber advantage beautifully, and they're going to just crush Rent-A-Homies and scrape them off the bottom of their boots to take a 4-1 lead.
Yeah, so 4-1, as you said, in favor of Street Hoops Esports. This is the match point for them. One more, and it's going to be in the bag. I'm going to watch Rikachu on this mid, the demo man for Rent-A-Homies. Hitting a pretty decent rollout there. But not quite sure if he's any faster than Duwana or not. My hotkey is rolling off there. Duwana hitting good upward spam, though, onto Fusion as he jumps in. Fusion doing a really good job of distracting, though. He hit, I think, every rocket that he shot, and he put Street Hoops on the ground in a pretty bad positioning, but still Street Hoops somehow coming out on top of that. Despite that strong initiation from the roamer over there on Ranta homies, that's gonna be a full wipe for the homies, whereas only Duwan has gone down on Street Hoops.
Yeah, and then Kozen has Uber. Duwana not being up is pretty important, though. We've seen Street Hoops just push as fast as possible behind Duwana's ridiculous skill, and I think a lot of that Highlander action where he just wants to take area and then seal off with stickies, but they're going to be a little bit slower getting into last, and maybe we'll see some Dooley Woosh magic. We have Rikachu underneath trying to hold off that bottom lane and relying on the rest of the five. We actually have a spy. I saw some invisible bullshit going on here, Lang. I don't know what's going on. I'm feeling like a Mackie play or something. My lord, how could that possibly be the play? Goku is gone crazy, and he's going off for a little walk while the point is going to be going down at this point. Right now, here comes the spy. He's going to walk in and watch the game end, and he'll be like, hey, can I just join you guys? He just won. GG, good job. And yeah, Street Hoops wins 5-1. And that was, we caught about, what, 4% of that game? That's fine.
Something like that. But yeah, that's actually going to do it for us tonight, guys, for the Team Fortress TV coverage of the Team Fortress TV Twitch Invitational. I want to thank Seabear for coming out of hibernation to come cast with me. He's back for less than 24 hours, and I have to immediately throw him back into the casting seat, so thank you for putting up with that.
That's not true, man. I'm casting tomorrow with Bloodsire, so I'll be going back. Yeah. Well, I assume. You never know with Justin. He's a tiny little guy, and his schedule changes, you know, so they might need him somewhere, like a midget wrestling match or something. But no, I don't know what we're casting. I assume it's another one of these games tomorrow on this channel, so check that out. Back to you, Lang!
Hold me closer, tiny sniper. No, I apologize. So yeah, you can check out that hot Bloodsire and Saber action right here on Team Fortress TV, or if that's a lie, it'll be on X Television. That's the great thing about this tournament. Both orgs working together to provide you all the coverage you could ever want, and then some, if we're being honest. But regardless, yeah, that's going to do it for us. Thank you for MathSad putting it down in production there.
Yeah, big thanks. It's great to be back into cast. I think that went well after we warmed up and everything. So thank you for watching, boys. I'm getting told that EXTV is also streaming right now, Lang. So maybe we can send... Yeah, why don't we... I mean, I always like to send people on stream bombs. We won't do that because that'll probably just get you banned. But go... I think it's twitch.tv/EXTV. Go check them out.
It's definitely also... not. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's twitch.tv/EXTV esports. I think that's what it is. Someone in the chat will figure this out and send people over there. Go watch the XTV cast if they're still alive.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. So, all right. Thanks so much. And shout out to MathSad for casting, or for not for casting. He didn't say a word. Well, he did. I don't know if you guys heard him. But great camera work. Had a lot of fun. We'll see you guys tomorrow night. Good night.
Bye.